Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In our previous video, we discussed tape drive shortcut menu options. In this video, we'll continue discussing other features or options. Please like, share, comment or suggest, subscribe for more videos, and you can follow us on Instagram. Let's start with media by location. There are two places where a media can reside, that is, either in the library or outside the library. The media in library pool is the logical repository for all media available in the library. Only exported media will not be displayed in this list. You can view the properties such as the media status, media barcode, storage policy used, location where the media resides, last write time, and size of the stored data for the media listed in this pool. The media icon helps identifying the media state and the operations that can be performed on each of these media. All of the information seen is from the Content tab. Click on Summary tab. Here you can get the overview, such as how many media are spare, how many are appendable, and how many are retired, etc. Please note, media in library pool is not applicable for standalone drives. Let's check what all options are available for this pool. Right-click on Media in Library. Set Location option helps to set the storage location for exported media. Set Export Location window. Here you see a list of the media for which you can set export location. Status displays the status of the media represented as an icon. The barcode number that is associated with the media. The type of media. And the current location of the media, that is, if the media is inside the library, the storage slot information or location is displayed. If the media is outside the library, then the location appears. Select the media whose export location you want to set. When new export location option is selected, you can assign a new export location for the selected media. You can select a location from the list or type a new location name in the box. When container option is selected, you can assign a container for the selected media. You can either select a container from the list or type a new container name in the box. Next option on media in library is export media. Export Media Wizard helps to perform an export operation. You can export media in bulk based on a list or on a criteria, which we covered in one of our other videos. We discussed about this window in detail in our other video, hence skipping it. Add to Favorites, as you know, helps to add this option to My Favorites. Up next is exported media. The exported media pool is also a logical repository for all media which are previously discovered and subsequently exported from the library. Ideally, you see the list of media that are exported from the library. We do not have any media that has been exported, so it's showing no items to display. Click Summary tab to get the overview of media, such as total exported media, of which how many are aged media, how many are spare media, etc. The first option to discuss from shortcut menu is set a location. As discussed before, set location option helps to set the storage location for exported media. As the error says, there are no exported media to set the location. But if there were media, then you should see the window that we discussed a while ago. The next available option is recall media. Recall media provides list of media that can be recalled, that is temporarily bring back from an export location for a specific task and return the media to the export location once the job is done. Example, sending tapes to Iron Mountain and recall them when needed for recovery and then send them back once the restore is completed. As the error says, there are no exported media to be recalled. But if there were media, you will see this recall window. We have these details displayed for each media. Status displays the status of the media represented as an icon. Like here you see aged media icon, appendable media icon, and a full media icon. The barcode that is associated with the media. The name of the storage policy used to write to the media. The current location of the exported media. The name of the container if the media was added to a container. Last write time is the most recent time data was written to the media. The total amount of data that was written to the media. The date when the data on the media will be aged. If you wish to recall all media, then select this option to select all media in the list. Once the recall action has been initiated, the media is returned to the library where it will remain either indefinitely or for a specific period of time depending on the option you selected. If you are using Vault Tracker to recall media, a new pending action is automatically created in the Vault Tracker Actions node, which you can track or modify if needed. The last option, Add to Favorites, which you already know. We will end this video here, and in our next video, we'll discuss media by groups. Do subscribe to our channel for more videos if not already done so. Thank you.
Do subscribe for more videos.